I'm gonna quickly like show y'all. It's not nothing in here right now, but I do want to show y'all so y'all can see what we got going on here. What's up, wealth babes? I am back with another video. In today's video, we are definitely about to continue with the couponing 101. So pretty much in this video, I am going to be going down my couponing journey, and you guys can follow along with me, do as I do or do as I say, because if I fall off, y'all know, just keep it going, because your girl think she's serious. But matter of fact, let me just have faith in myself. So definitely subscribe. You guys already know, if you click on these videos, you need to be subscribed to this channel. Get on this wealth wave. Make sure you thumbs up if you definitely want to see more content from me. And as always, drop the hashtag wealthbabe in the comments so I know you're part of the gang. All right, so let's go ahead and get right into this video. Okay, so guess what I got? The Amazon package came. It's right here. I'm about to do like a little unboxing with y'all. That should be fun. And before I unbox though, unpack, because this is not a box, it's clearly a package. Before I do that, let me say this. If you are just now watching your first video from me, before you finish this video, or before you get into this video, I should say, make sure you watch the other video about couponing, the one that was released on Monday. Couponing for beginners. That's what it says in the thumbnail. Watch that before you get into this one, because this one ain't gonna make sense if you ain't watched that one yet. So go ahead and get into that one. All right, so let's go ahead and unbox or unpack this little package. I'm about to grab these scissors. Matter of fact, these scissors, not even mine. These are my sister's scissors. She used them for hair, cutting hair, I think. And when she used them to cut my lashes. But I'm getting ready to cut open this. I hope I ain't cut this. Okay, I ain't cut what I thought. Okay. So, go ahead and unpack. Guess what it is? I got some, hopefully y'all can see this. I got some dividers. I didn't show you. What did I say? Oh, you could erase. I guess I don't know what I ordered. But these are the plastic dividers that's going to go in the notebook. I didn't show y'all that I ordered these when we last talked. And in fact, that brings me to my next item, which are the baseball card insert. So y'all probably, hopefully y'all can see. And once I open these further, you'll be able to see exactly how these inserts look once I get it out the packet, the plastic. The other thing I wanted to say is I definitely ended up having to buy a notebook that was not zipped. So I'm gonna show y'all this notebook. It's dirty. This notebook, it's a little flimsy notebook, but it's temporary. It's gonna work for now for what we're doing, but this is not gonna be the notebook that I keep over the long term, because it's just not gonna do. I can already see the stuff falling out of this flimsy little notebook. But I had to get it because these things came from Amazon way before the notebook came, the binder with the zip and binder. And I wanted to get this video up way before those or that notebook arrived. So y'all will eventually see the notebook and its final stage once it arrives. I'll just transfer everything out of this binder and put it in the one that I showed y'all in the previous video. So, yep, those are the items. And now let's go ahead and unpack this stuff even further. and put it in the, oops, I'm about to cut myself, y'all. Be careful with these scissors. Don't be like me trying to film and unpack at the same time. I really like the pastel color, the Vadas. So cute. And I'm about to just go ahead and put these in the binder. If I look crazy, that's because I'm trying to multitask and it's hard to film and do other stuff at the same time. So this is how the dividers look in the notebook. I hope y'all can already see what I'm doing without saying, but we gonna get there. We definitely gonna get there. So I'm opening this too. These are definitely for the coupons. Once we cut those babies out. Look, I'm gonna show y'all one. So hopefully you can see, but I'm gonna open this. It's one pocket for a coupon. And then here's another right here, and then another at the bottom. So each of these sections gonna have their own like category of coupons, and the dividers are pretty much going to be even further categorized. So let's just say, for example, I want to do like toiletries. The divider would say toiletries, and in each of these would be like toothpaste coupons, toothbrush coupons, I don't know, Listerine mouthwash coupons. So that's the whole little concept here. So go get y'all some inserts, go get y'all some dividers, and go get y'all a notebook, because it's about to get real. I need y'all to have these binders ready for when we hit these stores and cash out with $0. Is that possible? I don't know. But okay, let me put these inserts in the binder and I'll be right back. Okay, y'all, so the binder is looking good. I'm gonna quickly like show y'all. It's not nothing in here right now, but I do wanna show y'all so y'all can see what we got going on here. So I got a divider, a few inserts, divider, few inserts, and so on and so forth. So that's how the binder looks. It's a lot going on. We don't have no coupons in here just yet, but bear with me. Okay, so now that I have the binder complete, it's not complete because it doesn't have coupons in it, but I mean as far as getting it together and getting what I need as far as the inserts and the dividers in there. But I wanted to take a step back because I feel like we're just jumping into this. Well, I am, and y'all jumping in right with me without really understanding what this binder is all about. So I believe I've stated in the video about, dag, my camera died, and I think I'm hoping this is where I left off. I was saying that I have some notes from the seminar, so I do definitely want to go over exactly what the binder method entails. And once I go over that, I might clip a few coupons and insert them in the binder, and that's gonna be it. So if you still interested, keep on rocking with me. Let's finish this video. All right, so it says the binder method is the general idea with the binder is that you shop with all of your coupons in the binder. So get a good quality binder, one that's a show binder. I have the show binder because we have the clear inserts, the clear baseball card insert. So whenever you open that binder up when you're at the store, it's just going to be visible right then and there. You can't, you don't have to go through like pockets and pouches and try to pick out what you're looking for. when it comes to the coupons. So the quality binder, that's why I talked about the zipper binder, because I don't want to have to go to the store, right, and my binder starts getting raggedy and stuff just start falling out all over the place. Like, I'm very particular, so I definitely want to be able to just tuck all of this stuff away as I'm walking around any store that I'm in. And that's why I'm really pressed over the zip binder. So this little flimsy thing is definitely gonna be temporary until that one arrives. But I mean, if you don't have the money for the zip binder, by all means, sis, keep your flimsy binder, because it will get the job done too. So, okay. It then says, with the binder method, you are doing all of the work first. So you're clipping and you're organizing. The pros of using the binder is that your coupons are available during your shopping trip, and you can take advantage of any unadvertised sales that were not in your original shopping plan. So, for example, because all of your coupons are going to be in your binder and you're going to see what you are working with when it comes to your coupons, let's say you go to a store and you didn't plan to use some coupons that you know you have because you didn't know the things or the items that you want or know you need are on sale. You get to the store, you realize the sale, you know you got the coupons, go ahead and use those coupons and get those items that's on sale, because why not? You don't want to miss out on the sale. But if you was using it or doing it another way, which I'm not really gonna go into too much because it'll take way too long and I'm not trying to take up all y'all time. Y'all need to be using y'all time to study and figure out where y'all want to put y'all money in the stock market. I'm never gonna get that right, just face that on the first try. But y'all could be using y'all time to search up these companies. And then it goes on to say, advantages. You can see that you have, or you see that everything that you have, right? And then the disadvantages are, it's time consuming and you're maintaining expired coupons. It can be a tedious job. So you clipping out all of these coupons up front, inevitably things are gonna expire. You're gonna have to do the work to make sure you're keeping up, maintaining your binder to your standards, and so that you're out with the old and with the new on a weekly basis. So that's really one thing I want to put emphasis on, is that this isn't gonna be easy. This isn't gonna be something that we can pick up as a 5-minute hobby, if that makes sense. You have to dedicate your time to couponing, especially if you want to decrease your household items budget and also get your stuff for free. Like, you gotta take the time to coupon. So I am going to now share some tips that I have learned with you about maintaining the binder method. Since this is the method that I'm going with, maybe this is the method that you all will go with. If you don't want to go with the binder method and you want to learn some other methods, leave a comment below and let me know if you are interested in hearing about the other methods for extreme couponing. Okay, so on with the tips. It says, clip your coupons each week, sort and file the coupons, and pull your coupons each week as you plan your shopping trip. I might not do too much pulling because, like I said, I want to see everything when I'm in the store. I'm just going to take the binder with me. It says pull the coupons each week as you plan your shopping trip, but why? Why would I pull them? What am I going to do with them? Put them in a different folder or a file? I think that's adding too much work. So I'm just gonna skip that step and I'm gonna go with the other two tips that I just shared. pulling the coupons, as in clipping them each week, and also sorting and filing the coupons when I clip them. So there we have it. I don't know, this is all new to me. I feel like that's why I really want to film this journey and let y'all know, share any updates and or anything that I'm struggling with as we go down this road. Y'all let me know y'all questions. I will let y'all know what I learn as I go, and we just gonna keep it at that. So yep, let me know what y'all think about this. Comment below and really tell me if this is something that you're interested in doing, if you've already gone out to the stores to purchase your binders, or if you're already on Amazon shopping for your inserts so that you can put your coupons in it. And we will talk more about this later, because this is the journey. So I will talk to you guys later. Do know that if you do not fully, totally, and truly commit to being wealthy, you will not become wealthy. And I really mean that from the bottom of my heart. You have to put in the work to be the wealthy person that you aspire to be. So I'll leave that there. I will talk to you guys later. Mwah.